Fitzpatrick didn't give me much to go on. Just the newspaper photo of Malloy and the fact that Malloy stayed here at the Ritz. Then there's that girl Fitzpatrick referred to, Sandra. Maybe I can track her down. First, I need to find out which apartment Malloy was staying in and then get into it. That means I gotta deal with Nilo, my landlord. It's the second week of April, and I'm a little late on my February rent payment. So Fitzpatrick's staying at the Savoy. Guess I can call him on my vid phone if I need to talk with him. Ah, my trusty electronic shop credit card. The only way to go when you're out of cash. I'll pick up these clothes next time I'm expecting someone else in my bedroom. Yeah, fat chance of that. This door leads downstairs. Ah, the downy fresh hub of my swinging bachelor pad. Space girl Doris. With your own form-fitting air suit and come-hither smile. I still dream of you and a lunar landing. These are designer lights, as if there were any doubt. It's a small miniature camel. This is some sort of cool thing. I think that's a ceramic dog. I won this athletic supporter trophy in high school. I was the best third-string punter in the state. I'm currently reading The Maltese Fruitcake. Family's been passing it around for years. Amazingly, I made this horse out of a single coat hanger. These are designer lights. This is where I keep the elixirs and potions that help me maintain my boyish good looks. I had to pick up this Playbub issue. Had an interview with my favorite author, what's his name? It's my own little attempt at creative horticulture. My parents found this in the attic and sent it to me. I remember the pastoral days of my early youth, riding on my trusty Mount Striper, chasing bank robbers and horse thieves. And all that came to an end one summer afternoon during an electrical storm. The lightning struck a transformer near our home, creating a tremendous power surge. It was after the accident that my brothers and sisters started calling me Tex. Whenever I asked them, they'd just laugh and wink at each other. I never did find out about that nickname. I'll pick up these clothes next time. This is where I shave my face once a month, come rain or shine. Ah, soap on a rope. Grandpa Murphy buys this for all the grandkids every Christmas. This is the certificate and a copy of the check the Mutant League gave me after my last case. I used the cash to expand my office, buy some furniture, and pay off my debts. That left me with $4.12. Indoor plumbing is one of the many luxuries I try not to take for granted. Amazingly enough, this space-age cabinet came folded into a packet the size of a Triscuit. The guy who sold me this hormonatron said it would make women obsolete in my life, but I can't get it to work. This door connects to my rec room. That's the way back to my office. This door leads downstairs. This photo was taken at the last family reunion I attended. Has it really been 18 years? No matter how many lights I have in a room, there's always space for another lamp. These shelves contain some of my most cherished mementos. I call this painting Bleak Landscape. It's another beautiful night in the city I love. My favorite vase. I'm gonna start using this thing just as soon as I get in shape. That's the only computer in the office that works. I cut this article about Mac Malden out of the newspaper. Gives me a good chuckle. I cut this thing out of the paper a few days ago. I've known Mac Malden for years. We've worked together on several cases, but I don't know if we're actually friends. We just help each other out occasionally. Most of these computer components were purchased at a yard sale. The only one I've been able to get running is the little laptop on the shelf in front of the chair. This is a big photo of two horses. Why I have it and why it's actually hanging on my wall, I have no idea. Ah, it's one of my favorites. Bear in a trench coat. A reproduction of Fish and Fruit by the mutant surrealistic Saul Dooley. Most of these computer This barbell would provide a great workout if it weren't so darn heavy. This painting epitomizes my view of women as a gender. This alien landscape reminds me of the old Star Trek episode where they get that distress call, then Captain Kirk meets that beautiful woman, then he and Spock barely escape, then Kirk makes that funny joke right at the end. This is a breathtaking view of Saturn from the imaginary planet Alpha 19. This is the only pot I allow in my office. I got this from my grandpa, Audie Murphy. was signed by Richie Havens. Grandpa said he was the original singing detective. This painting always reminds me of something. I'm not sure what. I haven't played my phonograph since it destroyed the A-side on my Bill Shatner Sings the Blues LP. I'm very choosy about what I keep in my hutch. The current selection shows off my sensitive, artistic side. This office was a dance studio before I moved in. The watercolor plate is a lovely reminder of my favorite high school art class. These Gumby figures took third place in my 7th grade sculpting class. This wooden duck represents my ongoing commitment to wildlife preservation. This little gem cost me 120 llama cigarette coupons, but I think it's well worth it. This is an anatomically correct carving of my first pet, Barky. That's my prize collection of tribbles. A collection of my favorite poetry books. Someday, I'm gonna read every single one of them. Taco Bob. Got the most stylish placemats in town. This hot plate will come in handy if I eat anything other than saltines and dog food again. With all that these chairs have gone through, I feel like I could write a testimonial to the makers of Scotchgard. This baby's brand new. I had to replace the old one after the, incident. Lord, what a horrible memory. That's a New York Times bestseller, Men Are Imbeciles, Women Are Erratic. My mom sent this to help me with my love life. I've read the first chapter and I think the author's a hermaphrodite. Ritual virility is a guide to scoring with women. Step number one, get rich. My new vidphone is essential to my business. Thank goodness it's easy to operate. This picture was taken of my ex-wife on her 25th birthday. Yeah, she was gorgeous. Makes me wonder sometimes why we couldn't make it work. No one sits in this chair but yours truly. The guy who sold me this said it just might be an unsigned Picasso. It better be, because I paid $30. Couple more cases and I'll have this thing paid for. Then I'll start paying off my student loans. Took me forever to get this diploma. I had to send in 100 proofs of purchase from True Detective. Eat the rich dog food. A little gamey, but not bad for the price. I've had this jackknife ever since my Weeblos days. Rusty the Clown's Fun Book. The only pop-up book in existence with a must-be 18 years or older sticker. The scanner brings back some truly fond memories. Wonder how Trixie's doing. These drawers contain more worthless stuff than a Walmart bargain bin. These drawers contain... The 60-day warranty just ran out on my electronic shop fax machine. Should break down any minute now. I really need to find... Another can of Eat the Rich dog food. Well, at least I'll never starve. Yeah, it's taken me years to fill up these drawers. That's my Jane Mansfield coloring book and the Inspector Poirot mask I used last Halloween. Yeah, another bill from the electronic shop. I can't believe they expect me to pay for the junk they sell. Took me 3 days of hard work. I really need to find some stuff. These drawers are the holding area for stuff that's about to be tossed out in the trash. I borrowed this magazine on my last trip to the dentist. I've always been crazy for the Miracle Nails model. Ritual Virility is guilty as heck. The gripping saga of Lance Knight, the soft-boiled PI. One of these days, I'm gonna realize my dream of opening a spelunking shop in the Utah desert. I picked this book up at Rook's for a quarter. It's worth every penny. Rusty the Clown. Chandler Avenue recently got a city-funded cleanup. Now the street's darn near clean enough to eat off. Nothing kills these plants, and I ought to know. This is my official front door. It leads to the fire escape. I should probably stop by the newsstand and see if Chelsea's upset with me about last night. I've been trying to get her to go out with me for years now, and just when I think I might be getting somewhere, I stick my big foot in my mouth. Well, now I got some money, and maybe she'll give me another chance to let me take her out to dinner.
Hi, Tex.
Hey, I'm sorry about last night.
Is that so? Why?
Playing hard to get, huh? Okay, I'll play your little game.
I'm not in the mood, Tex. You know, this is not a game to me. I have a lot of big decisions to make, and maybe I need to get away to make them.
Hey. Everybody needs some space sometimes. Go if you have to, but I'll be waiting when you get back.
Thanks, Tex. I'll keep that in mind. So what's up?
Well, I got a bunch of cash, but I've got nothing to do with it. I figured I'd go out to dinner tonight, but I hate to eat alone. Are you interested?
What, like a date?
No, it'd be more like two friends having a great meal and maybe some stimulating conversation.
I guess that'd be okay. I mean, yeah, that'd be all right. You know, Tex, I haven't really been myself lately, and I really appreciate you looking out for me.
Where should we go? How about Burger Barn? They got great atmosphere at half the price.
I've got a better idea. Why don't you let me make you dinner at my place? It's cheaper than going out. And besides, I have something I'd like to talk to you about. Let's say 8 o'clock.
Well, you talked me into it, Miss Pandora.
Well, I feel so spoiled.
By the way, what should I bring, red or white?
You better bring both.
Finally. After years of relentless pursuit, Chelsea's inviting me over to her apartment for dinner. Oh man, the possibilities are making me woozy. Okay, snap out of it, Murphy, and let's get back to work here. Maybe I should head over to the Ritz and see if Nilo's at the front desk. I'm sure he'll be happy to see me.
Hold it right there, you sneaking piece of slop.
Hello, Nilo. Good to see you, too.
Ain't we polite today? Strolling in here like some kind of sunbeam from heaven. Tell you what, fork over the money you owe me, and I won't kick your butt all the way out into the street. That's more like it.
Well, now that we're all square, can you take a look at a photo for me?
No comprendi.
I said I can use your help.
I heard what you said. It's just my meter ran out. Of course, your C-note. So, what's on your mind?
Recognize the man in this photo?
Yeah, I've seen him before.
What can you tell me about it?
He used to stay here, gone now.
Which room did he stay in?
A.
What name did he use when he signed in?
Matthews. Tyson Matthews.
Okay. Well, thanks for the help.
Oh, the pleasure was all mine. P-Brick. Never heard of him. I ain't familiar with that name. Nope. We only stayed here a couple of weeks. Paid up front for 2 months. But he's too late to get a refund. What are you asking about me for? Want to ask me out on a date? Never heard of him. Ah, nicest guy on the street. Me and him, we talk the same language. I'd like to wipe the smile off that fat guy's face, but he ain't a bad cook. I got a few things I'd like to teach that Chelsea, if you know what I mean. Look, as long as you pay the rent, I don't care if you're the queen of freaking England.
Apartment A is through the door by Nilo's desk and up the stairs. Nilo's had a hard time keeping tenants, so Malloy was probably the last person to stay in the room. Hopefully I'll find a lead once I get inside. Nilo had these plants laminated to save on upkeep. The chairs match the sofa perfectly. They're vile-smelling roach nests, just like the sofa. This door leads to the upstairs apartments. Nilo is undisputed proof that man evolved from apes. Front desk is a miracle of particle board and wood paneling. This is where most of the residents come to get their mail. I have mine delivered right to my office so Nilo doesn't get a chance to spill on it. Looks like Chelsea's ready for business today. I don't know how Chelsea makes a living running the newsstand. Most of her customers are like me. Rusty the Clown used to own this place, then he mysteriously disappeared. In my last case, I found his body hidden in the back. Cops came in a few weeks ago and carried out Rusty's remains and locked everything up. Looks like the cops put one of their computerized locks on the door. The police were down in the sewer last week cleaning out the scum. That's the two-legged kind. Apparently some drug dealers were doing business in the tunnels below the street. I heard a deal went bad and someone got killed. The title to this warehouse has been passed around more times than a 50-cent piece. Right now it's owned by Acme Storage. The title to this warehouse... I guess they have to keep this door locked now that people are storing their stuff here. The title to this warehouse... A sermon on the joys of not eating meat, to be delivered by Reverend Gary. Okay. The Golden Gate Hotel was shut down a couple of months ago. Turns out it's a big fire trap. I hear the owners are planning on gutting it and then fixing it up. This place has been locked up for months. This mailbox used to be located by the Slice of Heaven. Federal discrimination laws require that it be moved to a new location on the first of every month. I guess this letter didn't quite make it into the mailbox. Uh-oh. Moral dilemma. To mail or not to mail? That is the question. I may regret this the next time I'm eating dog food for breakfast, but right now it feels pretty good. Streetlights here work about half the time, and usually during the day. Someone bought the old Bijou Theater and turned it into the Fuchsia Flamingo. I'm not sure if that's an improvement. Oh, the Coco Cabana. I heard that Clint, the local chocolate junkie, opened some kind of business up at Coit Tower. Coit Tower was one of the few San Francisco landmarks that survived World War III fully intact. The only thing in this neighborhood that's tackier than that marquee is Clint's toupee. Ritz Hotel. It's not much, but it's better than... Well, it's no worse than a dumpster. Ah, the electronic shop. I have to laugh every time I think about all the free stuff I picked up with my bogus electronic shop credit card. The bank's never open, and the ATM machine, of course, is broken. Go figure. Some unlucky soul lost his wallet. So, my landlord dropped his wallet, and it's full of cash. Of course, I could return it. These paintings are simple, elegant, and tasteful. They must have come with the hotel when Nilo bought it. I wouldn't sit on this sofa wearing anything less than a contamination suit. This mail drop box adds a nostalgic touch to the lobby. The vidphone's busted, but Nilo won't put an out-of-order sign on it. That'd just cut into his profits. Nilo must have found these magazines in the dumpster out back. The only magazines he pays for are the naughty ones. This piece of notebook paper looks like it's been used for a coaster. It looks like Nilo's in for a busy and productive day. Chairs match the sofa perfectly. They're vile-smelling roach nests, just like the sofa. Nilo hasn't had this vending machine stocked since I moved in. It'd probably cost money. Sheesh. This sandwich is about as fresh as Nilo's undershirt. Nilo says he buys these girly magazines for the articles. Unfortunately, he's usually reading them upside down. Nilo is undisputed. This painting must be called Sam and Max Hit the Semi. These boxes are full of Nilo's girly magazines. If you ever caught me checking them out, I'd be out on the street. Nilo says there's a naked woman hidden somewhere in this painting, but I think Nilo could find a naked woman hidden somewhere on a nickel. So, this is where Malloy stayed. The beginning of the trail. What a scumbag. Nilo knew I couldn't get into the apartment without the code. Now he'll probably want to charge me a few hundred bucks for it. At this rate, I'm going to be broke again in a hurry. I don't make a policy of getting to know my neighbors. The Ritz is the kind of place where people stay when they don't want to be found. A gentleman of the old school like myself would never enter the forbidden zone. I'd run naked through a nuclear reactor core before I'd set foot in there. This door is to my humble abode. The plant looks real, but it's actually part of the table. Low maintenance. The man in this painting looks vaguely like Nilo with a beard. This probably represents one of his twisted little fantasies. Nilo is undisputed.
What do you want? I'm busy here.
There's something I forgot to ask you. I figure I've paid you enough already, so you owe me.
Well, you figured wrong. You're off by about 500 bucks.
Come on, Nilo. You've cleaned me out already. I haven't even got enough money left to buy food.
Oh, boo-hoo-hoo. Here, let me give you some back. Ah, you didn't say the magic word. What a sap. So, what do you want to know? How to spot a sucker a mile away? Sucker a mile away, I like that.
Nilo looks around like he's about to sell some government secret and then lets me take a peek in his special notebook. The code is 4827.
Ah, got a whole new respect for you, Snotface.
contaminated area. No contamination around here? Wherever this ladder goes, it's got to be better than down here. I think I'll let that box float right where it is. Well, this box looks like it hasn't rotted through yet. A chisel. Maybe someone's been down here doing some prospecting. Well, this box looks like it hasn't. This magazine is filthy. I'll never get all the sewage off it. This looks like the kind of money belt that drug dealers are wearing these days. I used to play basketball two or three times a day when I was younger. Now, after I watch Jeopardy, I need a nap. I have to admit, Rook has an enviable collection of trash cans. Yeah, it looks like trash to me. Of course, one man's trash is another man's treasure. This is the back door to Rook's pawn shop. Well, it looks like Rook fixed this window with a little scotch tape. Looks great. Clint's old studio apartment. I wonder if it's for rent. Sure looks like this door's painted on. Yeah, the fire escaped to nowhere. Most of the fences and gates around the neighborhood are more symbolic than utilitarian. Dumpster smells like a compost pile, only worse. Looks like this side of the fuchsia flamingo didn't get painted. You can still see all the old markings from when it was the Bijou Theater. shortage of trash receptacles. Looks like a metal rod. Maybe an antenna. Chandler Avenue recently.